Today we're going to talk about power supply programming and readback accuracy. How is it calculated and how is it measured? In order to calculate the accuracy of a power supply, what goes into the specification calculation? When calculating the accuracy of a power supply for both programming and readback, many things are taken into account in the calculations. The ADC or DAC resolution is taken into account. The offset and linearity errors for these DACs and ADCs, the offset error and drift of op amps, thermal EMF of the shunts and self-heating effects of the shunt, gain errors of resistors and shunts, and also drift due to internal heating and ambient conditions. Here's a sample of a 6652A programming accuracy and readback accuracy from the datasheet. You can see the specification calls out the temperature at which it's calculated at, and it gives the programming accuracy for both voltage and current, and the readback accuracy is very similar. It's given for voltage and plus output current, and since the power supply can actually read some negative current, there's actually a specification for how accurate the negative current reading would be as well. In order to make the measurement correctly for a power supply, what we need to do is make sure that the DMM is hooked up at the same point where the sense leads are hooked up to the load. This is where the power supply is regulating to, and it's also where the power supply gets the information for the readback from. So you want to make sure that the sense lead and the DMM lead are attached together, and the DMM is not attached to the load lead where there could be some IR drops which would actually interfere with the accuracy of the measurement. You want to also make sure that your output leads from the power supply are twisted, short, and of sufficient gauge to keep voltage drops to a minimum. To check the programming accuracy of a power supply, what you would do is set the output to the desired output voltage and then measure the output voltage as shown before with a DMM. You would then take the DMM reading minus the VSET condition that was used, and that would be your error term. Then from the data sheet for the 6652A, we would take the condition where it was set at 12 volts, multiply that by the error, and add the offset error and come up with a total error for that operating condition of 17.2 millivolts. This error number should be between the limit of plus or minus 17.2 millivolts. If it is, then the power supply is meeting specification. For readback, it's similar. You would set the power supply to an output voltage, and then you would actually read back from the power supply, and you would read back from the DMM. You would take those two terms, the readback voltage, not the set voltage, and use that in the calculation here to figure out what the accuracy should be. So you take V readback minus the DMM reading, that gives you an error term. We calculate it up here, we read back 12 volts, multiply it by the gain error, and then add the offset term. We come up with a total error of plus or minus 23.4 millivolts for the power supply, and once again, that error term should be within plus or minus 23.4 millivolts in this condition for it to meet spec. I hope this has been helpful in explaining how to measure and how to calculate the accuracy specifications for our power supplies.